Phone problems. Okay. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Dig It With Raven. I'm Raven, and today we're going to talk about Archaeology 101. A lot of people think archaeology is actually paleontology. No, we are not Ross from Friends, though we do identify with him very, very much. It's just so cute. My first Archaeology 101 class, the professor asked a very simple question. Who here thinks that we're talking about dinosaurs? Most of them, yes. Literally half the class was shocked that we weren't going to talk about the T-Rex or watch Jurassic Park. Well, if you don't think of dinos, are you like Indiana Jones? Wrong. I wish. Though Indiana Jones is the main reason that most of us born after 1970 decided to become an archaeologist, it's not really that realistic about what we do. And no, we don't all get to wear those amazing hats, though we want to. If you find someone who does, take them for a beer because you know that they've actually done some really cool stuff. To get educational on you, the Oxford Dictionary describes archaeology as the study of human history and prehistory through the excavation of sites and the analysis of artifacts and other physical remains. That was a mouthful. Now take the definition, take it, and just throw it away. But not actually, it was pretty much true. It just sounds so boring. You can't describe archaeology in such a scientific way, even though it is a science. Archaeology is literally the most human thing that you can do in the world. Archaeologists dig up essentially what people leave behind. So you could go for a walk in the forest one day and start a fire, cook, leave it, you know, spend maximum an hour there, and that becomes an archaeological site. Hundreds and thousands of years from now, people are going to be digging through the dirt, looking at what you ate for lunch that day, and thinking that it is one of the most important things that they can be doing right now. All of that evidence, all of that fire, the food evidence, you sitting there, that all leaves a mark on the earth. And it stays there for crazy amounts of time, people. I'm talking hundreds of thousands of years. If you drop this pen, I dropped this pen on the ground and it happened to get covered by a rock or it fell into a body of water. It's like 10,000 years from now, someone's gonna pick up my pen. It's gonna become an artifact and it's gonna be worth tens of thousands of dollars. This $1 pen is therefore gonna turn into a priceless cultural artifact from the year 2016. My precious. Just like that evil Frenchman in the Lost Ark said, he had a great hat too. Like, what is it with archaeology requirement number one? Have to look good in hats. Archaeology is literally looking through people's garbage, or material culture, as the professionals like to put it. That's the job. Digging through trash, trying to figure out what these people were doing with their lives back then. Sometimes we literally dig in garbage pits. You're glorified garbage pickers, everybody. Don't try to argue with me. But Raven, what about the huge sites? The tombs, the palaces, the pyramids? Yeah, I know. It's not a garbage heap, but think about it. These are all places that people have left behind. Aside from tombs and gravestones and necropoli, these are things which were built to commemorate a person's life. All the other areas are places people left behind, whether they chose to or not. We literally dig up the things that people could not take with them. Yes, you get a valuable item every so often, but those have usually turned up in tombs or have been deemed so important and so precious that they've been passed down from generation to generation until they've made their way into a museum today where we can all ooh and ah for humanity. But here's what they don't tell you about archaeology. 80% of what you're gonna find is pottery. Boring! Is what I first said when I had to start studying it. But guys, it's so addicting, you have no idea. Why pottery, you ask? I'm gonna save most of this for another post, but it's because it lasts. Cooking pots, lamps, bowls, plates, cups, mugs. So many things are made out of clay. And when it broke, it was worthless. Don't need this anymore. The style and depth of complexity and what it was made out of can tell us so much about a site, about the people, about how advanced they were, and when they lived. Also, when you find pottery, it's the most surefire way to determine that you found civilization. Archaeology allows us to find out where, when, and how people lived, what was important to them, everything like that. When we find places like this, it's called a site. A site is a place where there are physical remains of a past culture. From there, we can get a sometimes clear picture of what people were doing. It's like a Facebook page for a slice of history.
Let me get my fake toga on here for a moment.
Not white, I'm sorry. For example, Roman Forum likes the Senate. Julius Caesar has just checked into Pompey's Theater with Gaius Cassius and Marcus Junius Brutus. Marcus Junius Brutus has just added 12 photos to the album Assassination of Julius Caesar. Hashtag winning. Gosh. Now let's talk a little bit about the different types of archaeology. Each one of these is going to get their video, a video of their own, but I just wanna touch on them here to give you a brief introduction. Don't worry, I just wanna familiarize you guys with them so you can choose your sides early. So archaeology can be broken down into two major sections. There's prehistoric archaeology and historic archaeology. Prehistoric archaeology deals with all the sites of human life before the written word. Once we started marking things down, and literally I mean marks on a tablet, we hit historical archaeology. Humans, as we know them, have been on Earth for thousands and thousands of years, so just think about how much there is to find. In fact, there's more to find with prehistorical archaeology than there is with historical archaeology, because we've only been writing for a very short amount of time. Like 99% of our history is prehistory, so we don't even know half of what we were doing before then. Now, within historical archaeology, there's tons and tons of subsections. Classical archaeology, Near Eastern archaeology, Biblical archaeology, Urban archaeology, North and South American archaeology, or New World archaeology, as some people call it, Far Eastern archaeology. Archaeology is even getting as sciencey as bioarchaeology, where people are studying the plants and all the organic remains found on the site. Then there's underwater archaeology. Did I just show bias there? Guys, seriously, I love all archaeology the same. Underwater archaeology is, you guessed it, archaeology underwater. Because humans hate staying in one place, and when they looked over onto this big blue piece body of water that you couldn't see to the other end of and thought, yeah, I bet I could cross that. I swear that must have been some drunken dare, however many thousands of years BC or it was. Hey, you think there's something on the other side of that big blue thing? Only one way to find out! Alright, that's it for today, folks. Thanks for listening to me for my first vlog. More to come. If you want a write-up on what archaeology is in 500 words or less, and some resources for extra reading, click on the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to stay up to date with the latest old news. And thanks for watching. Stay dirty, my friends.